Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. Today we'll be reviewing the Lego Star Wars AT-AT set 75288. Look at it. It's a pretty good design, I must say. Well, the new one, the UCS AT-AT, is, I think it's like twice the size. Really big. We might be doing a review about that later in the year, but let's stick to the normal AT-AT for now. You can see the figures, there's a speeder, E-Web, and of course, the AT-AT itself. Let's jump into it, not waste any time. Alright, let's look at the outer structure first. The way they've used it is by using Teknik pins in here to make the bones. And on the outside, they've used plates. This as the lock. Alright, we're going to explain the outer part now. Let's look at the cockpit first. This is a nice design for the cockpit view. The black part kind of symbolizes you can't really see what's inside, but it's still there. And they've got these twin proton blasters at the front. They've actually got some spring-loaded shooters, that's here. And the neck is an interesting design. It's fairly simple. Three of these round parts surrounding the middle part, which is the neck. In Star Wars lore, that is the weak spot of the ship. Okay, the legs are simple design as well. Pretty accurate, I'd say. Feet are pretty sturdy. They're not gonna like, you just push it and it's pretty good. It's pretty sturdy because it's got, well, one plate here, one plate here, one plate here. But there's also a small plate here on every side on the inside. But that's good. It doesn't need to be big like the middle. It's good. All right, let's go on the inside. I think we've pretty much covered everything now. Let's open it up and see in the inside. The cockpit, which I'll tilt for you here, can seat three people, two at the driver's spot and one at the back. The driver's spots are the AT-AT pilots, and the back spot is meant for General Veers, which leads the assault on Hoth Echo Base. Not much. There's a couple nice control panels here for the general to contact people, and some other panels for the drivers. Alright, let's have a look. This is the troopers transport area, a room for five troopers plus more if standing here, but it is a fact that here at the back the speeder can come in here, which I will show you later, and yeah, room for five. Surprisingly, there's only two snowtroopers, and I think there could be more, because like, what's the point of having five seats if there's only two snowtroopers? So they could have put five in there, but they've only got two. I guess it's not that much of a big deal, but like, seeing in the assault, if you had one snowtrooper on the speeder and one snowtrooper on the E-Web, there would be no infantry on the ground, which is why there should be three more, and that would make up a good attack force, make up a squad. Alright, I will show you one of the feature in the movies. Luke Skywalker races down here with his grappler gun, and the grappler gun actually can come down. It's a bit tricky to do though.
James can fast forward this part.
Can you jump in and bring in Luke? Just to demonstrate? Not yet.
This is Luke Skywalker in his pilotian form. This is when his land speeder, or snow speeder, crashed in front of an AT-AT, and he just jumps out in time before he's merely crushed by the foot of the AT-AT, before he proceeds to destroying the AT-AT and bringing it down. In the pilot's uniform, the chest pads here is pretty good. It's got some buttons and the leggings printing's good. The older models had the visor here on the helmet, but nowadays they don't bother and they just include it in the printing. It's also got another face, which is the visor up, and it looks pretty good. Lightsaber is the lightsaber, same as always. They never change it, which is good. Keep it the same. And now we'll move on to the snow troopers. These are the two snow speeders. They've got the classic short range rifle. I'm pretty sure this is supposed to symbolize the E-11 blaster rifle from the standard Imperial weapon. And the helmet masks over and kind of covers a bit of their shoulders. The older snow troopers had their little dress type skirt thingamajig, I don't know what to call it, down here, but I think they just put it in the printing. Under the helmets, there's a youngish guy, and then on the other one, it's an older guy that looks like he's got more experience. These snow troopers are the ones that man the E-Web and the snow speeder. And I'm not a magician, I'm just power of editing. The snow trooper here can man it by having one hand on it. There is a small problem with the E-Web, in my opinion. Most E-Webs, or all E-Webs, have the little battery on the side. This doesn't have it. The older AT-ATs did, which is a slight problem for me. And with the speeder, he just fits on like this. I like the handles because it's a simple design. I think it's supposed to be like a gas knob or like a fire hydrant on most sets. These down the bottom are supposed to be the where they control how fast they're going, but the minifigure can't even reach it. It's like way down. But yeah, it's not great, but these poles I think are long range blasters on a ship, like a TIE fighter or something. Wait, no, not a TIE fighter. Maybe like a civilian ship. But like the blaster on the bottom is a megaphone, just a black megaphone. Most megaphones are red or blue, but this one's a black one, which is, I think is a cool design. Here we have a significant individual in Imperial ranks from The Empire Strikes Back. He was promoted when the original Admiral was, I'm not quite sure of the word that Lord Vader did to him. And he led the assault on Hoth and taken back. He's got binoculars for scouting ahead. He's got a small mic so he can communicate with the other AT-ATs. He's in the head AT-AT, which is that one. And then now these two pilots. The exact same design. I really like these helmets. These helmets are a slight variation from the Imperial Stormtrooper helmets. They're a bit bulkier, but they're nice. I'm not quite sure in the set
that they had blaster pistols, but I added them just in case because I think they look better with blaster pistols. Because what's going to happen if Cal Kestis, Jedi Fallen Order, comes into an AT-AT and tries to hijack it? What are they going to do? Thanks for watching, everyone. Hit that subscribe button. And if you liked the video, press that like and comment down below what sets you think we should do next week, because we will be filming. Today, you might realize, is a triple attack run. Pretty sure we're going to be able to do 3 videos today, if not 2. One's already uploaded, so go to my channel, subscribe, and you might be able to catch the next one. And watch the one we've already uploaded. But, yeah.